Hey guys, so today's video will be my May favorites. So I don't have that many things, but I do have a couple of favorites that I wanted you guys to know about. So we're gonna just jump right into the video. So I'm going to start off with two things that you can find at your local beauty supply. Actually, no, three things, my bad. Three things that you can find at your local beauty supply store. The first one I'm gonna tell you guys about is makeup. And I know I've mentioned this on my channel before. This is the LA Girl Pro Conceal HD High Definition Concealer. Such a long name, but it's the LA Girl pretty much concealer. I use the color Pure Beige in the number GC976. And it looks like this. You can find it, like I said, at your local beauty supply. It's like $3, like $2.99 or something like that. And you can also find it online, but I've been loving this concealer for a long time. I switched between this one and the Maybelline Fit Me. It's like the creamy concealer, I think it is. But that one I also like. I pretty much go between both, but I will stick to this as long as I can get my hands on it. If not, you can always find it online, like I mentioned. But this is, I love this concealer. It's full coverage. And it goes on pretty thick, and it has this little like brush on it so that you can just pretty much brush it on. And I love it, love it, love it. And I use this to pretty much conceal under my eye area. And then I use it. I actually have another color as well, which I bought to highlight, but it was too light, so I'm not gonna even mention that one. So the next thing that I wanted to mention to you guys that I picked up at the beauty supply was this razor. It has this little cover on it, which is pretty safe for you to just put it away and store it and stuff like that, and keep it clean. But this razor I use to clean like the sides of my eyebrows, the top hairs as well, so that I don't have to tweeze them. I love it, and this is the first time I actually bought it. I think it was like 99¢ or like 79¢. Super inexpensive, but you can find this also. I know a lot of people that use it to like clean up this area and even like your stash, but my hairs are super, super, super light, so I don't even need that. I don't even need to do that, so I just use it for like my eyebrows to clean them up. The other thing that I picked up also was one of these combs. And this was, I think, like, again, like 69¢ or something like that. And I use it to part my hair. Like, if I braid my hair, I will use it to part it. And then if I put my hair up in a messy bun like this or like a top knot, I use it to make sure that everything is slicked back. So pretty good find at the beauty supply. Next thing, I wanted to let you guys know what I use to clean my face at night to remove my makeup. I've tried so many different wipes. I've tried the Neutrogena ones. I've tried all of them. My favorite has to be the Lavender Nighttime Soothing. And that one, I want to say it's like $5 or something like that, or like $6. But I came across the Equate Beauty ones, which is what you can find at Walmart. The reflection of the light is like throwing it off. But you find this at Walmart. It brings 40 towels, and it's only like 3 and change, and I cannot use certain ones. Like, this one doesn't make me break out, it doesn't make me dry, and it doesn't give me like that stingy feeling, because some of them will make you like irritated and it will like sting your skin for a little bit. But this one is pretty good, it doesn't do any of that. So I've stuck with these ever since I started using them, and I just will go back and get these. I tried the Target brand ones too, but the Target brand ones make me irritated for some reason. I don't know what it is, because they all have kind of the same ingredients, but I don't know. These work great. And again, you can find these at Walmart. This is the Walmart brand. The other thing that I picked up at Walgreens was this Airspun Loose Face Powder, and this is in the color Translucent. And this product right here has been around for a long time. From what I've heard, it says on here since 1935. So, hence the date. So what it is, it's pretty much, it's a loose powder. A lot of people have been using this, if you haven't already came across it on YouTube, but they use it in comparison to the Laura Mercier loose powder, they use it to bake. So I have been using it to bake. Not as much lately because it's been super hot here in Florida. So I've been just using it to pretty much dab it all over my face because I get so oily. But with this stuff, it's been really good. And I know that it comes in another shade. I think it's tan or something like that. And it's inexpensive. If I'm not mistaken, it was like $7.99 or something like that. And now if I keep looking that way, it's because my window's right there and I have it open for the light. And I'm a little nosy. Like, these birds keep coming by and it's like creepy. But anyways. But this is good stuff. So if you can find it at your local Walgreens, is where I found it. Yeah, Walgreens. Pick it up and see if you like it. And the only thing is, I've heard a couple of people complain about it. The smell. It smells like, the smell is a little strong. I'm not even gonna front. It smells like vieja. Does that mean? It smells like, not an old lady scent, because old ladies don't have scents, but it smells like that old school, like, perfume, like roses. I don't know. And I normally like rose scents, but this stuff is still good. I will still use it. Okay, so moving on to the Wet n Wild highlighting powders. Check these out. Oh my god, the reflection. You know what? I'm not even gonna do that. I'm gonna just open it. Look at that. It's so pretty. That one was the Precious Petals, which is my favorite. And then this is the Crown of My Canopy, which is more of like a, this one's more of like a champagne color, and this one has more of like a peachy color to it, which is super pretty. If you guys can see that, look at that. And these were limited edition. I picked these up, I think it was either at the end of April or April or the beginning of May. But I picked them up at Walgreens. They were the last two there, so I was so happy because I went to a couple other Walgreens and they didn't have any left. They did a pretty good job. Wet n Wild definitely surprised me on these because I did pick up one of their powders that they released right before these. It's like a, oh my god, what is it called? It's like a face illuminizer or something like that. And I didn't like it. The pigmentation was off. Like, I didn't like it at all. But these are amazing. Let me just, for the sake of the video, give you guys a swatch on my hand so you guys can see. So this is Precious Petals. That's it right there. Look at it. Look at that. It's so pretty. And then this is Crown of My Canopy. I put my nail in it, look. Oh my god. This is Precious Petal. Precious Petals, and because I just took a big chunk of it, you'll see it. That's Precious. No, that's Crown of My Canopy right here, and that is Precious Petals. I know the light is throwing it off a little bit, but that is so pretty. This is, no, what do I have on now? I have Precious Petals on my cheeks right now. So it's super pretty. I know that it's limited edition. I normally wouldn't want to even mention it because you can't get it anymore. But if you do come across it at your local Walgreens, because I know they do release at different times in different places. And here in Florida, they already came out. So I don't know if you can maybe get them online. Definitely a must have. Then the last product I want to talk to you guys about is the Milani Conceal and Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation and Concealer. This stuff right here is amazing. Do you guys remember, I think it was a couple of weeks ago or maybe even like a month ago or so, I mentioned that I think I may have found my favorite foundation. This has been it. So I got the color Sand Beige. It's the number 6. And I have a lot of yellow tones. I have a yellow tone, so I like it. I am the shade NC40 in MAC, in Studio Fix. That's what I use for MAC. So when I found this, hands down, I kind of thought it was a dupe for the Studio Fix because of the consistency. It's pretty, it's medium to full coverage. It's lightweight. It doesn't have any oil. Like, it's oil free. It's long wearing. They say it's water resistant and sweat proof, but after this weekend with SMF, I don't think that's true. However, it did hold me down for a little bit. So I did love it throughout this weekend. I've loved it for the last month. So if you can get your hands on it, they have a lot of good tones, like a lot of shades. I was very amazed by them releasing a lot of like the darker tones. So they have a good selection of those, but the lighter colors, I've heard a lot of mixed reviews on it. So if you could find it in your tone and give it a try, I would definitely recommend it. So that's all that I have for you guys for my May favorites. It wasn't too many products, but it was a lot of new products that I have been using, at least new to me, and I felt like you guys needed to know about it. But if you have any questions, you have any comments, leave me some comments below. Again, all of the products that I did mention will be listed below. There is a little down arrow. You can hit it and everything will be listed. Again, if you haven't subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. Again, thank you so much for watching my video, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.